First thing, what if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle means this is the line, D is the line which is drawn parallel to one side of the triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct point. If a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other sides in distinct point means two different points. Parallelly we can draw this also, this will be parallel, but it will touch at one point. But this should touch at two points. Sometimes it may not touch the triangle. So that's why this distinct point is very important. If the other two sides in distinct points, then they divide in the same ways. So first, what is given here? So in triangle ABC, D and E are points on AB and AC such that D is parallel to BC. So this is given point. Okay, na? Next, RTP what? RTP required to prove AD by they will divide the if a line drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other sides in distinct points, other two sides you can divide means it's better. Two sides in distinct point, then they divide in the same ratio. Then they divide in the same ratio means AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Next, we have to, for proving this, we have to draw a construction. Construction, first, what we will do means join DC and
BE.
Draw DM perpendicular to AC and EN perpendicular to AB. So here we'll draw what? Draw DM perpendicular to AC and EN perpendicular to AB. Okay, no? So and join BE and BE and CD. Okay, no? Proof. First, before proving this, what is the area of a triangle? What is the area of triangle formula? Like that. If this is a triangle, is there? Okay, na? A, B, C. So area of triangle is, if the corresponding altitude, I'll draw like this. This is base B. Half BH will say. Half BH. Base into altitude. Then suppose I'll draw a right angle triangle. If this is acute angle triangle like this. If right angle triangle means this will be altitude H, this is B, then the area of triangle is half BH, half base into altitude. Suppose the triangle is like this. Now tell me, what is the area of this triangle? Where can I draw altitude? I have to extend this line and draw this altitude. This is 90 degrees. So altitude is outside the triangle and this is base. So half B into H. Okay, na? So half base into altitude. Suppose there are number of triangles are there here. Like this also there. like this also there one triangle, and I am drawing a altitude here B. So here A, B, C, D. Can you say what is the area of triangle ABC? ABC, ABC, D, D, and I'll write here E. What is the area of triangle ABC? Half BC into H. Half BC into altitude H, AD.
Half BC.
Or if I'll say area of triangle ABD, na half BD into H. If I'll say the triangle AB, half B into H. Okay, na. So anyway, the base and corresponding altitude gets. In the same way, see what is the area of triangle, area of triangle. Okay, first let's see one thing. What is this diagram? Like this, it is there. Okay. Now this is D, and we joined what? A, B, C. This is DC, this is B, and I drawn a perpendicular here, DM. Here I drawn a perpendicular, EN. Now, what is the area of triangle ADE? If I consider AD is the base, AD I'll consider base means, what is the area of triangle here?
Area of triangle?
Half,
half
AD into EN. Now if I will consider this is the base, AE is the base, what is the area of the triangle then? Half AE into corresponding altitude. Half AE into DM. Now see this triangle. Half area of triangle BD. BDE. What is the area of the triangle then? Half.
BD
into
BD into
EN. Corresponding altitude. Altitude is that side. Corresponding altitude from this. Now see this side of the triangle. What is the area of triangle?
Half.
EC
into
DM. Now see, this triangle and this triangle, see BDE triangle and CDE triangle are on the same base, and DE is parallel to BC, already given. So DE is parallel to BC, the same if a triangle is there like this, and this line is parallel, na? This line is parallel, then wherever the triangle you will draw, na, from here, if the area will be always equal. That means area of triangle BDE and area of triangle CD are equal. So if you divide this both, na, what happens? EN cancels, half cancels, EN half cancels, DM cancels, we will get AD by DV is equal to AE by is the same proof, only we have to write it properly. Understood this proof? Now see, area of triangle ADE. Now tell me, what is the area of triangle ADE? Half. What I told?
Half
AD into EN. Area of triangle BDE. Half.
Half
BD into half BD
into
EN. Half BD into EN. So area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle BDE is equal to half AD into EN divided by half BD into EN. So half of cancels, EN cancels, then what will get? AD by BD. This is equation 1. So directly we will write similarly, area of triangle ADE divided by area of triangle CDE. what happens?
Half by DM.
So DM half of cancels. DM cancels. AE by C. This is equation number 2. Now, triangle BDE and triangle CDE are on the same base D, and D is parallel to BC. Therefore, area of triangle ADE is equal to area of triangle BDE is equal to area of triangle CDE. This is equation number 3. Means here see, area of triangle BDE, CDE are equal. Already area of triangle ADE, AD are equal. Therefore, AD
by
BD is equal to AE
by
C. Hence, prove. This theorem is very important. Every time which used to come in the public exams. Okay, now.